In this screencast, I'm going to discuss how to study. This is the second in the series. The idea is based on the literature from psychology about how learning takes place. The first screencast discussed practice testing. Here I'm going to discuss distributive practice and interleave practice. So one approach to study might be to spend an hour studying calculus, for example, and then the next hour also studying calculus, and the next hour also. That's not the best approach based on the literature. Instead, it's much better to spread things out. So study a topic, wait. And so this is the important aspect. As you wait longer before you study again, not surprising, you're going to forget more. So for example, if this were 1 or 2 days, and then you study again, you've forgotten much of it. So the trick is to make this time so the information is barely retrievable. In other words, you want to be able to retrieve it, but it's not going to be easy. You have to work to retrieve it, and that actually reinforces. And then after you study again, now you wait longer than before. Here I'm saying you wait longer, you forget more, so you can't wait too long. But after the second study, waiting longer and then studying again, it's going to result in longer term retention. And then of course the idea, wait even longer and study again. So continuing this idea. And part of the concept behind this approach is that if you are able to retrieve something from memory, it's going to be even more retrievable in the future. One of the studies that looked at this is fairly dramatic in the differences. So this is looking at the proportion of answers that were correct. And this is doing a test. And there were 6 study sessions. For the black circles, there were no days between those sessions, and the retention, the percent correct, looks really good. But what you'll notice then, after a 30-day wait following the last study session, the retention is the lowest of the 3 approaches. This case, there's 1 day between sessions. This case, actually, there were 30 days. But let's look at, for 1 day instead of on the same day, same amount of studying, retention is significantly higher. And this is the idea of spacing out the studying. And this was for even spaced, even better where the spacing gets longer. And so this relates to the first topic about practice testing, that practice testing is better when it's distributed, then it's going to be better than just distributed study. So spacing out the practice testing is desirable based on these studies. The third one is to interleave practice. And the idea is if I have 2 hours of study, I could spend this on one topic. For example, solving a certain type of differential equation. Studies would say we don't want to do that. I want to spend some time on topic 1, and then spend some time on topic 2, which certainly can be related, but not the same thing. In the studies, for example, might be some of the studies were solving different types of math problems, but all in the same general area of geometry. And then topic 3, and then maybe topic 2, and then maybe topic 3, maybe topic 1. But the idea is this actually improves learning. And let's look at some data. So this compares blocked, approach we said we don't want to use, versus interleaving. So again, notice the idea that practice performance, the accuracy is less when we're practicing using this approach, but it's dramatically higher than on a delayed test we test performance. So studying and right at the time, like we've talked about, performance is not going to be as good, but when the actual longer term retention, performance is dramatically better.